Indeed, it is awesome. But how does this affect performance?
Well, note the sequence of steps here. When we encountered the script tag, we had to pause DOM construction and let JavaScript run before we could continue. JavaScript is set to be parser blocking because it blocks DOM construction when we encounter the script tag.
I see. But that doesn't seem like that big of a deal. JavaScript is pretty fast, right?
It is, but let me make a slight modification. Instead of using an inline script like what we have here on the bottom, let's say we move the script contents into an external file like what we have here. What would you expect to happen now?
Well, same as before. The parser finds a script tag, fetches the file, and executes it. Oh, wait. Oh, I see. This fetch could take a while, right? And while the browser is fetching this file, the browser is blocked and can't continue constructing the DOM, which would in turn slow down the critical rendering path.
Exactly. The script tag blocks the parser from proceeding, and we're stuck waiting for this file. Not a good outcome.
So, if external JavaScript always blocks the parser, it sounds like I should just inline all of my JavaScript.
Well, yes and no. You're right in that inlining the JavaScript would help eliminate the request, but there's some downsides as well. For example, if you use the same code on multiple pages, then that would be redundant code on all those pages. So there are trade-offs here.
All right, but for code that's specific to one page, that seems like a pretty good strategy.
Yeah, that's reasonable, but let's take a look at some of the trade-offs and the gotchas associated with them.